Well, here today I want to discuss a little bit what would be the relation between negative transfer uncertainty and foot recognition. So as Professor Madani said, I'm from the University of Barcelona. I'm head of the Computer Vision Machine Learning Laboratory at the University of Barcelona. And also I'm senior researcher in Computer Vision Center. Okay, and what will we discuss in this talk? I would like to go very fast on discussing a few concepts like negative transfer, uncertainty modeling, GANs, how to use GANs for epistemic uncertainty data augmentation, and conclusions. So today, probably nobody will argue that we are living in the era.
Sorry, I think we are seeing the first slide, aren't we? Can you share the slides again?
I stopped sharing.
I think the presentation was freeze on the first slide.
Probably, yes. In fact, also I saw that.
Sometimes it happens with Zoom. Okay, it's not. It's okay now.
Yeah, perfect. So Adventures. Now it's both. Okay. Yeah. Thank you very much. Thanks.
Okay, so today, probably nobody will argue that we are living in the century of the deep learning. So deep learning today is outperforming most of the problems in not only in computer vision, in machine learning, but also in very other fields. But if we want to summarize what is making deep learning so popular, let us look for these three features that are making it very popular. One of them could be the self-learned high-level feature representation. That is, we have end-to-end learning systems. We don't need to bother about what kind of information shall we extract from the images in order to give to the classifier. The second advantage is the modularity of the deep learning models. Today, we can easily construct different architectures and adapt different architectures to solve different problems. And also the third very important aspect is transfer learning. And the transfer learning is here, the idea is how to build this model that instead of doing from scratch, that is time consuming and expensive, we want to reuse the existing knowledge that we already acquired before in different domains and in different tasks. So instead of always beginning for each new problem from with a different models and beginning from